Here are a few quick tips on getting Metro Exodus running and set up the way you want. In this video, I will focus exclusively on the Microsoft Store and Xbox Game Pass for PC editions of Metro Exodus. If you're unable to install the game from the Microsoft Store because the install button is grayed out, make sure you have the required Windows version installed. Scrolling down to the system's requirements for the game will let you know which version you need. My Windows actually told me I had the latest version installed, yet my version was lower than the minimum version required for Metro Exodus. This is because at the time of this video, a Windows Insider build is needed for Metro Exodus and also for other games. To fix this, either follow the download link to install the Windows Insider build, or, and this is my recommendation, download the new Xbox app that is in beta. You can find the link in the description below. When installing the Xbox app, it will automatically install the Windows Insider build you need. The first time you launch the game, Microsoft will try to connect the game to your account. I have seen this result either in a crash or an error during the verifying process, and it seems to happen if your region or date and time format in Windows does not match your Microsoft account settings or your current location. So make sure you double check your Windows settings for region and date and time format before launching the game. Also try launching the game in safe mode when Metro Exodus asks you to, which is after a crash occurs. In my case, I first had to launch the game in safe mode to stop it from crashing after the intro. After that, I got an error from Microsoft, and only after I changed my date and time settings back to my regional settings, Microsoft was able to bind the game to my account. Once that was done, I could finally launch Metro Exodus without using the safe mode. Some changes to in-game settings, such as motion blur or FOV, can only be done by editing the config file, as there are no in-game settings for that. I'll put a link in the description where you can find the most important settings that can be changed in the config file, but first you'll have to locate the config file, and that isn't straightforward when using the Microsoft Store or Xbox app. For some strange reason, it's not in the usual places, but hidden in your local app data under Packages and Deep Silver Project Windfall. So copy-paste the link from the description into your Windows Explorer and you're halfway there. From there, you'll have to go through the folders and open the files in there with Notepad. Only one of the files will have readable content, and this is your configuration file for Metro Exodus. This is not so much a tip, but more of a sad observation, because even though there is an in-game setting to change from DirectX 12 to 11, at the time of this video, changing the setting does not work for the Microsoft Store and Xbox app version of the game. So those are some of the issues I ran into, and I hope the solutions and explanations will be helpful for you guys. After a while, I managed to get the game running and get it stable enough to play. And I hope you will be too, as the game is definitely worth playing. I apologize for the shaky voice, I am a little sick at the moment. If this video was helpful to you, please consider giving it a thumbs up and subscribing to my channel. Thanks a lot and see you next time.
Oh, I can't believe my eyes! Artyom, you're alright! You gave us a scare, brother!
Artyom! How are you, friend? I see
Pardon
you're all
me,
right.
Gentlemen, give
this
way.
Calls for a celebration.
Artyom, a few more scars and you will be completely irresistible to any woman. Speaking of which,
Alyosha,
how are the nurses in the hospital,
guys,
huh?
Could you just stop crowding him?
Brother.
Welcome back, Artyom.
Privyet, Artyom.
All right, you're all dismissed. I give you 2 hours, people.
Yeah!
Oh, it's official.
Yeah, I knew it.
You guys are like this.
So I brought something.
And here we go.
Please, let's not repeat the last
Hold
time.
Hold on, Artyom.